So hi, my name is Deanna Janzen. I work in the Memarzadeh Lab at UCLA. I'm a PhD scientist there, and basically what I do is I study women's cancers to see why they might form and to try and find better ways to cure the cancers. So one of the cancers we study is endometrial cancer, and usually this is treated by surgery, but it has a lot of side effects. So one of the ways we're looking to treat it is to use a hormone that women normally have in their body, progesterone. So doses of progesterone can sometimes cure the endometrial cancer, but it only works for certain women. So we're trying to find out ways to determine which women this therapy will work on, and are there other drugs that we can give with the progesterone to make it more effective? So actually, I grew up in Wisconsin, pretty much right around the Milwaukee area, so it's about 90 miles north of Chicago. And I actually always was drawn to science. It was my favorite subject in school. I just like finding out the way things work. My mother was she started out as a secretary and then she was an accountant. And when I try to explain what I do to her, it's sometimes very interesting. But I'm sure she feels the same way when she tries to explain loans and stocks and bonds to me. And my dad was an accountant, so I guess there's a bit of a math background in my family, but not necessarily science. What's great about science to me is I come into work every day and I have a new problem. I don't have to do the same thing every day. I have experiments that are different from day to day. There's always something new to learn. You've never reached your limit in science. You've never found the final answer. There's always more you can ask about a question. So one of the biggest things I do in the lab is I study populations of cells in cancers. Particularly right now I'm looking at serous ovarian cancers, and I'm trying to find out why some cells in the cancer are able to evade common treatments like platinum drugs that are used to treat them. So if I can find how the cells are evading the therapy, I might find ways to sensitize them to the drugs or find other drugs that can kill these cells, and in that way we'd be able to remove more of the tumor burden from people and hopefully prevent recurrence. So if we can find a way to just treat women with this hormone progesterone, they wouldn't have to undergo surgery. It's a lot less healing time and there's a lot less side effects. Since progesterone's a natural substance, you don't have a lot of the side effects that you would with chemotherapy or radiation. So patients feel healthier and they have a better quality of life. The tools are one of the fun parts of science. So there are a lot of tools that I get to work with. I spend a lot of time on microscopes. I use regular light microscopes to look at cells that I'm growing. And I use fluorescent microscopes to look at cells that I've stained with antibodies so I can see what proteins the cells express or where in the overall cancer a certain set of cells would lie. I do use math a lot and it's a very important skill, but I don't have to be a math genius. I can use just basic math that I've learned early in my high school career to answer most of the questions I need. And whenever I have a question about math that I can't answer, there are always other people on campus that I go to. There are times where I'll do a stretch of work by myself, but there's a lot of interaction in the lab because no one can answer all the questions themselves. So I'll do part of an experiment and then I'll talk to someone else who's working on another part of the experiment and we'll compare our results and see how they interact with each other and what data we've learned and how this comes together as a whole to answer the questions. So if I were going to talk to somebody about career in science, I'd tell them that basically just about the interesting things that you do, the fact that your job is different every day. I don't go sit at a desk and punch on my computer and have to be in a meeting for 5 hours at a time. I get to see different things. I get to go work on different machines. There's always something new to learn. Being on a college campus is wonderful because there are so many different places you can go to find out the answers to questions you don't necessarily know.